welcome back to TPS. New England Patriots quarterback Tom Brady is the greatest draft steal in NFL history. He was drafted 199th overall in the 2000 draft, following four seasons with the Michigan Wolverines. Brady was a backup in his first 2 years in Ann Arbor and was merely average when he was a starter in 1998 and 99. Brady is obviously the greatest player to ever come out of Michigan, but believe it or not, there's quite a list of Wolverines quarterbacks who are far better than Brady at the college level.
At TPS, we post videos every single day, so don't forget to click the subscribe button to subscribe. Then click the notification bell to be notified when we post a new video.
Number 9, Steve Smith. No, not the guy who helped the New York Giants win Super Bowl 42. And no, not the perennial Pro Bowler who dominated with the Carolina Panthers for over a decade. Another Steve Smith, one who actually never played in the NFL. This version of Steve Smith played for the Michigan Wolverines from 1980 to 1983, and he was a starter for the final 3 years. Smith dazzled as a dual-threat quarterback under legendary college football head coach Bo Schembechler. Smith led the Wolverines to a blowout win over the UCLA Bruins in the 1981 Astro Blue Bonnet Bowl. 2 years later, Smith guided Michigan to a 1983 Rose Bowl appearance, where they fell to the Bruins. In his final year of college, Smith took Michigan to the 1984 Sugar Bowl, but they lost to the Auburn Tigers. In all, Smith threw for 4,860 yards and 42 touchdowns against 32 interceptions during his 4 years at Michigan. He also compiled a whopping 1,737 rushing yards and 31 touchdowns. He surpassed the 600-yard rushing mark in the 1981 and 83 seasons, which is kind of ridiculous. Among other honors, Smith also earned a spot on the 1982 All-Big Ten Conference football team. Despite a successful tenure at Michigan, Smith never played in the NFL. He went to play for Montreal CFL team in 1984 before joining the Ottawa Roughriders in 1985. Smith joined the San Diego Chargers the following year, but he never played a snap for them. But hey, he can always brag about being better than Tom Brady was at Michigan. Number 8, Todd Collins. Collins saw limited playing time in his first 2 years of college football in the 1991 and 92 seasons. When the previous starter graduated and went to the NFL, Collins finally took over as Michigan starter in 1993. Collins flourished in his first year as the starter, throwing for 2,509 yards and 17 touchdowns against 7 interceptions. Michigan finished with an 8-4 record, and Collins guided them to a Hall of Fame bowl victory over North Carolina State. In 1994, Collins surpassed 2,500 yards once again to go along with 13 touchdowns. Michigan finished with an identical 8-4, and they deflated Colorado State in the Holiday Bowl, with Collins being named Offensive Player of the Game. His 64.3 completion percentage is the best in Wolverines history. Collins also ranks 6th all-time in passing yards and 8th all-time in passing touchdowns among Michigan's quarterbacks. Collins played in the NFL from 1995 to 2010, primarily as a backup quarterback. He had 22 career touchdowns against 24 interceptions. Number 7, Devin Gardner. Gardner was on the Wolverines roster from 2010 to 14, though he saw very limited action in his first 2 years. Michigan decided to use Gardner as a wide receiver, but he had to take over as the quarterback when starter Denard Robinson went down with an elbow injury. Gardner flourished in 2012, his first year as a starter, with 1,219 yards and 11 touchdowns against 5 interceptions. Michigan finished 8-5 before falling to South Carolina in the Outback Bowl. Gardner had his best season in 2013, throwing for 2,960 yards and 21 touchdowns, while rushing for 483 yards and 11 touchdowns. Michigan lost to Kansas State in the Buffalo Wild Wings Bowl, however. Gardner struggled a bit in his final year in 2014 as Michigan finished with a woeful 5-7 record that led to Jim Harbaugh replacing Brady Hoke as head coach the following year. Gardner went undrafted before signing with the New England Patriots in 2015, only to be waived a short time later. Gardner never played a snap in the NFL. He later went to the X-League, then signed with the Saskatchewan Roughriders in the CFL in 2018, but he was released late in the season. But hey, the guy still performed better than Tom Brady ever did at Michigan. Gardner sits 4th all-time among Wolverines in passing yards and 6th in touchdowns. Number 6, Jim Harbaugh. You kids obviously know Jim Harbaugh is the head coach of none other than the Michigan Wolverines. Life's a circle, and of course y'all remember him as the former head coach of the Stanford Cardinals and San Francisco 49ers. But you kids may not know that Harbaugh was a standout quarterback at Michigan from 1983 to 86, taking over after Steve Smith graduated. Harbaugh only attempted 5 passes in his first year. After a promising start in 1984, Harbaugh suffered a gruesome broken left arm that ended his season, and he was replaced by Chris Zerbrug. Finally, Harbaugh displayed his superstardom in 1985, recording 1,976 passing yards and 18 touchdowns against only 6 interceptions, leading the Wolverines to a 10-1-1 record. Michigan finished number 2 overall in the final AP poll. Harbaugh guided Michigan to a Fiesta Bowl victory over Nebraska. In 1986, his final season of college ball, Harbaugh enjoyed his best season yet. He threw for 2,729 yards and 10 touchdowns, though Harbaugh also had 11 interceptions. Michigan finished with an 11-2 record, though they lost to Arizona State in the Rose Bowl. Harbaugh was named the Big Ten MVP in his final year, and he finished third in Heisman voting, losing it to Vinny Testaverde. Harbaugh played in the NFL from 1987 to 2000, making stops in Chicago, Indianapolis, Baltimore, and San Diego. His best years came with the Colts. Harbaugh was named a Pro Bowler in 1995 and won the Comeback Player of the Year award, leading the Colts to an AFC Championship game appearance where they narrowly lost to the Pittsburgh Steelers. After leaving his head coaching job with the 49ers following the 2014 season, Harbaugh went back to his alma mater and became head coach of the Wolverines in 2015. Number 5, Denard Robinson. Robinson saw limited playing time in his 2009 freshman year, but he took over as the Wolverine starter in 2010, and boy did he deliver. Robinson completed 62.5% of his passes for 2,570 yards and 18 touchdowns against 11 interceptions. He also rushed for a ridiculous 1,702 yards and 14 touchdowns. That made him the first college quarterback to ever hit 1,500 passing yards and 1,500 rushing yards in a single season. Michigan finished with a 7-6 record but lost to Mississippi State in the Gator Bowl. Robinson was named a 2010 First Team All-American plus the Big Ten Offensive Player of the Year. Robinson threw for 2,173 yards and 20 touchdowns in 2011 while compiling 1,176 rushing yards and 16 touchdowns. Michigan finished 11-2 and defeated Virginia Tech in the Sugar Bowl by a score of 23-20. He was named to the First Team All-Big Ten for the second year in a row. Robinson had 1,319 passing yards and 1,266 rushing yards in his final season, with 16 total touchdowns. His 4,495 career rushing yards are the most in Wolverines history, and Robinson's 49 touchdown passes stand as the fourth most in the school's history. Robinson was a fifth-round pick of the Jacksonville Jaguars in 2013. He spent 4 seasons as a running back and receiver, but was out of the league after the 2016 season. So yeah, he'll always be better remembered for what he did as a Wolverine rather than what he did in the NFL. Number 4, Elvis Grbach. Elvis joined the Wolverines in 1989 and split the duties with Michael Taylor. That year, Grbach completed 62.9% of his passes for 824 yards and 8 touchdowns against 3 interceptions, and the Wolverines fell to USC in the Rose Bowl. Grbach became the starter in 1990 and performed nicely with 1,911 yards and 21 touchdowns against 10 interceptions. Grbach led the Wolverines to a 9-3 record, and they defeated Ole Miss 35-3 in the Rose Bowl. Grbach also turned Desmond Howard into the 1991 Heisman Trophy winner. The latter had 985 receiving yards, 19 touchdown receptions, and 412 yards in his historic season. Grbach had his most productive campaign in 1991, completing 65% of his passes for 2,085 yards and 25 touchdowns. Michigan went 10-2 and reached the Rose Bowl again, losing 34-14 to Washington. Grbach won the Sammy Baugh Trophy in 1992 after leading Michigan to a 9-0-3 record and a big Rose Bowl victory over Washington. That year, Grbach had 1,640 passing yards and 17 touchdowns. Grbach ranks third all-time in passing yards at Michigan with 6,460, and his 71 touchdown passes place him second. Grbach was drafted in the 8th round by the San Francisco 49ers in 1993. Despite his strong showing at college, he only saw limited success at the NFL level. He did win a Super Bowl XXIX championship as Steve Young's backup, and Grbach did lead the Kansas City Chiefs to a 13-win season in 1997. However, they fell to the Denver Broncos in the divisional round. Elvis played in the NFL until the 2001 season, finishing with 16,774 passing yards and 99 touchdowns against 81 interceptions. He made history in a 2000 game between the Chiefs and Raiders, throwing for 504 yards and 2 touchdowns in a losing effort. Grbach became the 8th quarterback to join the 500-yard club, and the first in 4 years at the time. It would be 6 years until Drew Brees became the next person to join the club. Number 3, Rick Leach. Some will say that Leach may be the greatest quarterback in Michigan Wolverines history, and it would be hard to argue with them. Leach's 46-33 career touchdown-to-interception ratio may not turn heads, but his 2,171 yards and 34 touchdowns on the ground should, not to mention his 129.7 quarterback rating. He was a four-year starter at Michigan from 1975 to 78, and his ability to use his legs was exactly what head coach Bo Schembechler was looking for in a quarterback. Leach broke plenty of passing records at Michigan during a time when high-flying offenses were few and far between. He also led the Wolverines to three straight Rose Bowls. Leach earned All-American status in both football and baseball at Ann Arbor, but he would go on to pursue a professional career in the latter, spending 10 years in the majors between 1981 and 1990. So why isn't Leach number one on this list? Well, that would have to do with his 0-4 record in bowl games. But hey, he was still better than Brady. Number 2, John Navarre. In his first years of college in 2000, John was forced to take over for an injured Drew Henson. The latter ultimately returned and regained his starting job. But Navarre became the number one quarterback in his sophomore 2001 year. That year, Navarre threw for 2,195 yards and 17 touchdowns against 12 interceptions. Michigan finished with an 8-4 record, and they fell to Tennessee in the Citrus Bowl. The following year, Navarre had 2,905 yards and 21 touchdowns, and he led Michigan to an Outback Bowl victory against Florida. Navarre absolutely dominated in his senior 2003 season, going off for 3,331 yards and 24 touchdowns. The passing yards and 270 completions were single-season Wolverines records. Michigan went 10-3 and finished 6th in the final AP poll. However, they lost to USC in the Rose Bowl. Navarre was drafted in the 7th round by the Arizona Cardinals in 2004, but he only played 2 games for them. He was out of the NFL after the 2006 season. Still, Navarre left Michigan as one of its all-time greatest athletes. His 9,014 yards and 744 completions are second most in the school's history, and he's third all-time among Wolverines with 70 touchdown passes. And number 1, Chad Henne. He's the king of Michigan Wolverines quarterbacks, the legend of legends, the icon of all icons. That's strictly in regards to college football, of course. Henne was miles better than Tom Brady in college, and it wasn't even close. Actually, Henne was heads and shoulders above just about every other quarterback to ever suit up for Michigan. Henne was a starter from his freshman 2004 season to his senior 2007 campaign. Henne surpassed 2,500 yards in each of his first 3 seasons. He totaled 70 touchdown passes over that 3-year span. Kind of ridiculous, we know. In 2004, Henne led Michigan to a 9-3 record and a Rose Bowl appearance where they lost to Texas. A year later, the Wolverines went 7-5 and narrowly fell to Nebraska in the Alamo Bowl. In 2006, Michigan went 11-2 but lost in the Rose Bowl yet again, this time to USC. Finally, Michigan broke through Henne's send-off year, and they went 9-4 and defeated Florida in a thrilling Capital One Bowl contest, 41-35. Henne was a first-team All-Big Ten selection in his senior year. He left Michigan as their all-time passing yards leader with 9,715 and as their all-time completions leader with 828 and as their all-time passing touchdowns leader with 87. All of those records still stand today. Of course, Henne struggled at the NFL level. He was drafted by the Miami Dolphins in the second round in 2008. He played there until 2011 and joined the Jacksonville Jaguars in 2012, where he stayed on as their backup until 2017. Henne signed with the Kansas City Chiefs to back up Patrick Mahomes in 2018. Henne went up against Brady 5 times as a member of the Dolphins and once when he was with Jacksonville in 2012. Henne led the Dolphins to a 22-21 victory over the Patriots in Week 13 of the 2009 season. So for one day at least, Henne was better than Brady at both the college and professional level. What other Michigan Wolverines quarterbacks were better than Tom Brady at the collegiate level? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. We'll see you guys next time.